And the discussion here, Lauren Zarian, LZ, joins us. And it's weird because normally we would be having, I would say, a frothier conversation.
Oh, yes.
Pearls are in, this is out, that kind of thing.
And you know what was fascinating is watching, you know, being a part of it and watching it last night, mm-hmm. I watched it with such a different eye. Mm. You know, I've never been one to slam anybody. I look at a dress or an outfit and think somebody could have worn it differently because right. It's not celebrating who that person is. But last night when I watched it, it was just a different way to look at the awards. Mm-hmm. Now, the Golden Globes red carpet has been home to many iconic fashion moments. But last night's red carpet was fueled by one mantra: stand out, stand up. And that's exactly what Hollywood did. Black dresses ruled the red carpet in a show of solidarity for the mission of the anti-sexual harassment group Time's Up, which demands for an end to sexual discrimination and harassment in the entertainment industry. With red carpets often dominated by talk of dresses, hair, pearls, jewels, and with that effort, the Time's Up is steering the conversation towards its agenda. It's bigger than a best dress list. It's a moment that becomes a movement, and that it did. But as your KTLA fashion guy, it's my job to talk the talk, and the conversation is definitely different. So let's take a walk down that glorious red carpet and celebrate some of the talented, brave, courageous, beautiful women that walked the red and black. First up, Reese Witherspoon. Nominated for Big Little Lies, was chic and sophisticated in a Zac Posen column gown with an origami neckline and Bulgari jewels. Beautiful, right?
Mm-hmm. There, yeah.
Sophisticated. And I love when her hair is completely slicked back. Next up, Viola Davis. The hair, the necklace,
yeah.
The dress. Viola was definitely on fire, giving us a lot of Diana Ross.
Great.
And a curve-hugging Brandon Maxwell dress with a sweetheart neckline and a 111-carat Harry necklace.
Is that all?
Wow.
You know what? I love that she went in black, but I love that she infused an element of fun.
Yes.
And she really was giving Ain't No Mountain High Enough with that Diana Ross.
Yeah.
All right, next up, Margot Robbie, nominated for I, Tonya. Goes for the gold in a deep-cut Gucci gown.
I like this. Very
with silver sequin ribbon embroidery and Roger Vivier accessories, plus Tiffany & Co. jewelry.
But this bare bodice, this was the big thing.
That deep V.
The deep V.
The deep V.
Okay, yes.
Yes.
And she had the right goods to carry off a deep V.
Right.
Sometimes when women are more fuller chested,
sure,
it doesn't compliment too much because you're looking at everything that's not.
And the hair's great.
Encased in the deep V. Yes. Next up, Christina Hendricks oozed movie star glam as she wrapped her gorgeous figure in a form-fitting black gown with a velvet bodice that covered a smart
pants?
Set of black capri pants.
Yes.
As a thin strap of fabric circled her lithe waist with a smoky eye and a berry lip. And this is probably the best I've ever seen Christina on a red carpet.
I can never go with the capri pants. Sorry.
Oh,
really?
Well. Yeah.
Well, because you're not a woman.
I'm done with you.
What do you think, Jessica? Did you like it?
Tell them your thing.
You know what? I was hoping for the Time's Up thing that we all wore pants.
Yes.
That was the statement. Instead of all in black, but all of us wear pants.
Would you be down with that?
I would love it, but as we're going to see some more, pants were really one of the hottest trends on the red carpet.
A lot of the ladies.
Next up, Tracee Ellis Ross was Fab and Fierce.
I love her so much.
And Marc Jacobs.
And she's
the
takes a risk every time.
Every time.
No, she's the coolest person around. Really.
I literally have become obsessed by her. She was wearing Marc Jacobs from head to toe, including a satin turban, halter dress, and black jogger pants, plus
amazing.
Irene Neuwirth jewelry. It was just fierce and celebrated what the moment is of that night and Time's Up. And next up, Oprah Winfrey accepts the Cecil B. DeMille Award in an off-the-shoulder black gown with an embellished neckline and train.
I think that's one of the prettiest looks I've seen for Oprah, to her hair
and
her
the
glasses.
Best glasses ever.
The whole
and
thing.
Her run for presidency. I gotta say, that speech, literally, I looked at her and listened to everything she had to say. Number one, I love that women were celebrating women. But number two, it was great to see the men celebrate women as well.
Do you know about the glasses, by the way? Glasses?
Well, no, she just needs them to see.
No, I just wondered
there was a celebration. No, it was just a great, great night all around.
The quickest question, does this continue all the way through Oscars or not?
I have a feeling yes. I have a feeling this conversation hasn't ended at all. And I will say this, I'm wearing this great watch from The Watch Gang. And the reason why I put it on is because it constantly reminded me and reminds me what last night was about. Time's Up in celebrating women. There's something that's going to shift. Conversation will change in what I do. Dialogue will completely be different.
Well, that's interesting.
And pants! Jessica is officially wearing pants to the Oscar telecast.
Whether Mark likes it or not.
No, I like the long pants and that kind of stuff. Okay. Just the culottes. I'm not culottes.
Thank you, Elsie.